tonight is obviously concerto class, and I'd just like to make a couple of remarks. Last night, when I was accompanying, or Bob Ray was accompanying singers, our job was to balance. Now, technically speaking, if the people who are playing tonight were playing with orchestra on stage, to a certain extent, the conductor will do his best to balance. But the situation is very different because you've got 100 men in the orchestra against one pianist, which means I want the second pianist to play as big as possible to give us an idea of the fact that when you're playing a concerto, your projection must be almost double in terms of volume and strength than if you're playing solo. You've got to cut through. If you're playing like I did at the opening of the season with the Philadelphia Orchestra, the Barber, I literally was giving 2 to 3 times what I would normally give in a recital. Which brings me to the simple point that there are so many people who think that the life of a concert artist is glamorous and you travel a lot and it's great, and to which I always say, you take an airplane in a crowded terminal, you try to get a cab from the airport to the hotel, you frantically look for a place to practice, you eat, you sleep, you play the concert, you get nervous. Before the concert, hopefully it goes well, you might read good reviews or bad reviews the next morning, you're gone. It takes tremendous physical stamina and tremendous ability to just let unimportant things go and concentrate on the important things. It is slave labor. That doesn't mean that we don't love it, we don't enjoy it, but there's an awful lot of just plain hard work involved and a lot of just grinding routine. As any of the pianists here will say, you know, 7-8 hours a day practicing is not the thing we'd most always like to do, but we have to do it. Otherwise, we can't do the kind of performances that we want to do. So the old adage of 90% perspiration and 10% inspiration is still true. So again, all second pianists, play big.